To now. Oh. So. Oh, if they don't want to get beaten, we'll send them to you. I see. But did you have a, you did have a similar experience like Brother Willis? Not Ian and ever run from you. Ain't none of the children ever run from you.
No.
Oh no, they stood there, take yours. Okay, they didn't take that chance. So I would say, I could go on record in saying that Brad, you were the first one to experience discipline from, because this is your first grand, eh? Brad, is your first grand?
First grand.
Brad, stand up, let them see you. This is the Hendfield's first grand. And he's doing well. He gave them some great grands. How many? Three, right? He gave them three great grands. That's wonderful. Are three of them here?
Yeah.
Where's the daughter? Oh, she's sleeping. Okay. And this is Brad's wife. Come on, stand up, Shania. Let them see Brad's wife. Okay, and the son's right here. Come, stand. Hey, Papa Brown.
All right.
This one was sitting up in the chair. He was taller than he sits in the chair, but he stood up on the ground. And this is very important that you know. This is so you say you got beaten from your grandparents? You don't recall? No, beaten this man when the bell hit you. But the Willis, you knock him in all his memory. He don't even recall that. That's interesting. But here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask another question, because we have a lot of prizes. We have so much prizes, we didn't even give away one. I want to ask a question. No, before I do that, let me have some more tributes from the shepherds who are here. Bishop Rudolph Arthur. He served as their pastor for about, I think, 7 years there, about, Bishop? About that. Somebody I can stitch a seat, the microphone right here. Come on, let's give Bishop Arthur a round of applause.
Blessed good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Yes.
Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that putteth their trust in him. I am indeed so delighted and so happy to be able to come and join with the family of Brother and Sister Hendfield, who is celebrating such a great milestone in their lives today. This is truly wonderful. And I would like for those of you in the audience to give the children a good round of applause for thinking about this and doing this. You have a lot of children, you know, many of them sometimes forget how mommy and daddy had to struggle and, you know, did so much to bring them to the place where they are today. They forget. But I thank you, children, for doing this for mom and dad. And I would like to really congratulate Brother and Sister Hendfield on their 57 years of marriage. I know it wasn't always easy. There were times when you had your valleys, and there were times when you were on the mountaintop. But through it all, like I said, we have learned to trust in Jesus. Through it all, the Lord helped you to reach thus far. 57 years, that's a long time. But God is good. And we can say today that God has kept you, and because of that, we can come and celebrate with you 57 years, and also Sister Jean, 80 years. God bless you, sister. Go for another 80. Go for another 80 years. Go for another 80 years. Now, of course, we don't know what plans the Lord has, but that's what I'm saying. God knows the future, and God has the future in his hand. But I was delighted to have served them for a very short period of time. I didn't know them personally. I saw them, but I really get to know them when I went to Seawick in 2001. And But you know, Sister Hendfield is more, Sister Russell, we call her Sister T, is more on the quiet side. But don't let that quietness fool you. She is strong in the Lord.
Yes.
And whenever she speaks, what a fellow called E.F. Hutton will.
Everybody is.
Everybody, take note.
That's right.
Whenever she opened her mouth, all around gotta keep silent or listen to what she has to say. And of course, Brother Willis says, you know, he is a great teacher. A great teacher. And if I were to try to find a word for both of them, I'd say faithful. That's what I would say, faithful. They are. Yes, give them a chance. During my 6 years, they were in Sunday school. I don't know, but I gotta say, I don't know, because sometimes I miss more Sunday school than them. But every Sunday during those 6 years, the only way they were not in Sunday school, and especially Brother Willis, for some reason or other, he just loved to teach, just like to talk about the goodness of God. I never find him when he don't have something positive to say about the goodness of God and this. He always have a scripture. And always, and you can wake him up midnight, 4 day. If you say B, he could say A. He is really versed in the word of God. And so I say to you, to both of you, God bless you, we love you, we appreciate you, and go for another 57 years. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Bishop. Thank you very much. You know, Bishop said something about Brother Willis, which is so true. He always got a scripture, and he studied the word. And Pastor Jennings has used the word when he described Brother Willis, like christic. You know, you can say it when you come. It was something, you know. And he takes the word literally, Jan. There was some time we had a men's, but Benton, you might recall, we had the men's ministry. We did one, a session in secret one time, and we was talking about different things. But Willis challenged us. We said he used the Ten Commandments, and I think it's the Eighth Commandment there about where it said, thou shalt not steal. And he took that literally in all things. He said, you should not steal. And what baffled me was when I challenged him about Magic Johnson and Isaiah Thomas on the basketball court. And I said, what if Magic going down the court, dribbling the ball, and Isaiah come behind him and steal the ball? He said, that's wrong. The Bible said, thou should not steal. I said, but that's a basketball game. Stealing is a part of the game. Yeah, but he shouldn't do that. He shouldn't steal. And I'm trying to wonder if, you know, if it's the different type of steal. You know, he's telling me steal is steal. And he calls me now when I watch basketball, can a nice fella stealing the ball? I go, oh, you shouldn't do that, but let us say, thou should not steal. You know, but like I said, he take the word literally, man. You know, he's deep. He's deep in it. And you can tell he's passionate about what he does, because whenever he talks, he gets into position. He'll be standing up like how I'm standing up now. And just to explain one iota, if I say, Brother Willis, what is God to you?
God.
God is God.
And if you would have, if you would put it in perspective, and he is a man, you can't
put God in the box.
You have to remember.
I mean, his body getting all kind of shape to get one on, so just to say God is everything, he can bring, come on, let's give it a minute around. But coming now with remarks is the pastor who I believe pastored them the longest since they was in Seagrape. For some 20 years, Pastor Joseph Taylor will bring remarks at this time.
Thank you very much, Brother Will. This is really a blessing and an honor. And Benton called us last week. I mean, you know, we put everything off so that we can be here. I believe I know these two people better than most of you in here. remember going into Seagrave 20 years ago. Seagrave was at a very, very low age, low state. We had something like, I believe, 30 or 25 members, and about 10 was attending church at the time. And brother and sister Theresa were the two persons who stood with me during those rugged, rugged years and brought that work to what we leave it at the time we left. And I was able to really see the children, the whole family, not just brother and sister Willis, but the entire family. I was able to see the children go through school, see them grow up, some of them got married, and today God has tremendously blessed them. Brother Willis is a walking Bible. Many of you might know that. It's a walking Bible. And I commend them both for being married for such a long time. Yeah. We ought to give them another round of applause. Yeah. And I can tell you, I was there in a difficult time. It wasn't easy. It wasn't easy, but God, like he says, when he went to the pine yard, I believe God set his approval upon this marriage. And if they made 57 years, I'm sure they're going to make the rest of it, because they kind of grow up together. Sister Marissa, when I went in secret 20 years ago, you didn't look no different.
That's true.
I'm telling you.
Yeah, yeah.
And come on, give the woman a hand.
Yes, sir.
The scripture says God said, beautified in me with what?
Salvation. Yes, sir.
And I'm going to tell you something about Sister T before I close. When I first went into Seagrave, don't mind not looking so pious, but if she has something to tell you, amen. Jen, am I right or am I right? she's going to do it in love. And if you will leave you sometime, man, this is the rest laughing. God bless you. It is these kind of people that made my ministry to be a successful ministry through the commitment of brother and sister Theresa. I don't want to say, Sister T, Brother Will, thank you so much for your tremendous support during the time that I was here. God will ever bless you. God bless you.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Pastor Taylor, for your kind words.
One more thing.
20 years, Sister Theresa had never, my knowledge, missed a Sunday school.
Wow. Oh. Amen. That's wonderful. That's a good report. That's a wonderful report. And he's right, you know, Sister T ain't look no different. All the pictures I could think of from back then, she looked just like that. She would be wearing a different color dress and hat every now and again, but she looked the same. But Willis ain't look good. Well, he had afro. He had afro then, but, you know, but other than that, he looked the same. And I mean, all these 57 years, 80 years old, look at him. Not a strand of gray. I'm telling you, God is good. Yes, yes, God is good. Yeah. But we're coming now to... Their current pastor is coming now to bring some remarks. Let's welcome him at this time, Pastor Dwight Jennings, as he comes with his remarks. Yeah, this is interesting. Mr. Rafa Leader, it's good to see you. Looks so good in this red.
Good afternoon to all.
Good afternoon.
So God be the glory. Great things he has done. If I was to describe Brother Hendfield and Sister Hendfield, I'll use the word dedicated. Very, very dedicated to the service of the Lord. Sister Hendfield, my Sunday school teacher. She is part of the reason why I love the Word of God. Also, she epitomized the Proverbs 31 and 10 woman. You know, she's very industrious, right? Run her own business, get up early in the morning and make sure her house is provided for. And so when I think about Sister Theresa, I think about the Proverbs 31 and 10. The word, Brother Will, that you were asking about with Brother Willis, I love that word, linguistic. Yeah, every time I need to to learn a new word or to hear sequence of words. Brother Willis always have a word. He's very well schooled and taught in the word of the Lord. And any scriptures that you might have difficulty with.
Yes.
Huh?
Even thou
shalt stay. You can go to Brother Willis and Brother Willis will be able to break that down to you in the Hebrew and the Greek and all of that he will be able to. So they have been very, very, very helpful and very, very dedicated and very, very meaningful to me in my life because they made such great contribution. And I say to you, Brother Willis and Sister Hendfield, keep on keeping on. God bless you. Your labor is not in vain in the Lord. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Pastor Gary. Come on, you can do better than that. This is like a report card day.
Yeah.
You're hearing all the reports as to how they were and is as members and individuals. Like that. And now coming now with remarks, your older sister sent some sort of representation. And representing the older sister is her daughter, Colleen, don't tell me, Forbes. Colleen Forbes, let's give her a round of applause please as she comes. She wants to speak about her auntie. Her auntie who she loves so dear. So dear. Oh, she said, I got that right. Yeah, she got a bigoty walk too. Yeah, Colleen, look at she knows Skylark. That's a bigoty walk. Go ahead, take the microphone and speak with your auntie girl.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon,
Colleen. Happy anniversary. Happy birthday. May God bless you all. I have a special message from your older sister, Mrs. Leo Palmer, who is 98 years old. She asked me to convey to you all blessings, long life, and she loves you all very much. She says she's unable to be here, as you know. She can't move unless we move her. But that's
about it. Wonderful. Thank you very much, Colleen. God bless you. You tell your mommy thanks. That's a good message she sent. Tell her she sent the right one to send it. That's right. You know, talking about the Hendfields, I know, Liberty, your children love you. When you talk to your children and they talk about your parents, they always have this concern and Big H and me are pretty tight, and I guess if I give him the microphone to talk, he wouldn't be able to talk, he'd break down and cry. This brother loved his parents so much, and that's the reason why I say I'm here. I'm supposed to be in a Nassau, but I'm here. Ben Benton talked to me about his parents. This brother's break down and cry. He said he remember, and Brother Willis, the life you live in, continue to do that because Benton is watching you. I mean, Kenneth is watching you, but Benton, I can speak of Benton. Me and Kenneth ain't tight. Is Benton, you know, but me and Benton are tight, and whenever he talked with you, he always break down and cry. He said he remembered the time when you came out of the hospital. He was in hospital for a period of time, and you came out of the hospital on a Sunday, went straight to church, opened church, and gone in Sunday school. He said how your commitment to the work that you do, and I mean, the brother just said, oh my God, I continue doing what you do in front of your children, the life that you live. They're watching you. And Sister T, continue to do the show the love that you're showing to your husband because I believe your daughters are watching you. That's how Basil and Lyndon can look so prosperous now because these wives are doing what you do to him, to their husbands. Am I right? And that's how that comes to husband is in science. Yes, so continue to do what you're doing for your children, okay? And that's wonderful. I just love that when children can show the appreciation for their parents because you know, I tell them I only got one mother. She's the first to ever love me. She'll be the last one I forget. Absolutely, absolutely. And right now I'm going to ask some questions. I need someone from the superstar table to come here, please. Someone from the superstar table. I need someone from Alice and Crew to come. I need someone from Conquerors to come. I need someone from over here. Y'all ain't get me to say that name again. Each table sent a representative. Come. I need come, come here. Pastor Tyrone, send your wife. And you quarter. Now I'm gonna ask them. Come on, okay, who's coming? The Dane you're representing?
Yeah.
Judah
House, Judah, tribe of Judah. Benika, you're representing? Oh, redeemed by the blood. Benika, come up here and represent the redeemed by the blood. What's your name? Your name is? Karima? Karima, you're representing that table. I don't call the name, I was gonna mix up with that name. Who's representing this table? Jan, you come, yes, you're good representative. Come represent your table. Oh, Cox is representing the Alice and crew.
Yeah.
Tell who's representing this table. Okay, Nelly, yes, good choice. Nelly's representing this table. Jan. You said Mikey. Go ahead, Mikey, represent. They want you to represent them. They said they want you to represent them. They were set. They said this one called for man. They were set man. And she's the last girl is representing considerate. And who's representing the precious? Man is representing precious. Come, represent precious. Come, represent. Man is representing this thing. Kel, let's go. Represent. Right, so he said his brother. Okay. Each table is represented here today. Shh. Ladies and gentlemen, we have prizes that will be given after the question. And here's what I want. You must say the table that you're representing, and we go from there. All right? After the question is asked. Ladies and gentlemen, you cannot help the person that's representing you. Okay? You cannot help them. Well, Jaden is having the time of his life. Shh! I need extreme silence. Brother Hendfield, you please come. You're representing, what's the name of your table? Superstars. I'm going to ask you a question. And audience, please, no outburst. No loud outburst, please. Every tub got to stand on its own bottom. You're representing the tables on the ground. Your grandparents are watching you. They believe in you. They believe that you're a science boy. Prove them right. Your question is this. Two fathers and two sons went fishing. They caught three fish. Each had one. How is that possible? Two fathers and two sons went fishing. They caught three fish, each had one. You don't know? Okay. Do me a favor. Go up there in the penalty box for me. Upstairs. Come on stage. Go to the penalty box. Superstars, y'all ain't looking good. Y'all ain't looking good. Upstairs. Go upstairs. Ready? Penalty box. Upstairs. Penalty box. Representing the precious. Come back here. Come to me. Your question is this. A boy was walking downtown with a doctor. The boy is the doctor's son. But the doctor is not the boy's father. Matthew Jones Mills. How is... Hold on, I think I asked it wrong. A boy was walking downtown Freeport with a doctor. The boy is the doctor's son. But the doctor ain't the boy daddy. How is that possible, precious table? I don't repeat it twice. I ain't supposed to do this, but by is you. A boy was walking downtown with a doctor. The boy is the doctor's son. But the doctor is not the boy's father. Matty Mills, how is that possible?
He was the same person.
Matty joined Brother Hendfield in the box. In the penalty box. That's two tables that are in the penalty box. Alice and crew, your representative is coming. Come in to me, Cox.
That's why they send me.
That's why they send you. They send you. Yeah, they're tricky. Yours can be easy. Yours can be easy. You happen to be a minister in the great church of God. I'll ask you a biblical question. Shh! Audience, please know a first. How many different species of animal did Moses take on the ark with him?
12?
Join them in the penalty box. Alison Crew, that's the best you all send. Well, your best is in the penny box. Redeemed by the blood. They sent Benika Hendfield. Benika, come here to me. They say Tink. Benika, I want you to say the word post 5 times. Say it fast, post. What do you put in the toaster? Toast? Join them in the penalty box. Miss Rafaelita, tell your granddaughter what you put in the toaster. Yeah. But Nika, you hear the answer? Yeah, that's the answer for next time. But you can tell me what's not with you. The dean is representing
Judah!
Judah! The tribe of Judah!
Shh.
Judah, you represent the tribe of Judah. A cowboy rides into town on Friday. Shh, honestly, the onus. Stays for 3 days and leaves on Friday. Just the Hamden. How is that possible? Say, he never left, even though I said what I said. A cowboy rides into town on Friday, stays for 3 days, and leaves on Friday. If the baby came from his ear, she said, just a hand in. How is that possible? Shh, audience. Yeah. Stay for 3 days and leave on Friday. How is that possible? You don't know. Join them in the headphones, please. Wow. Bishop Arthur, can I find one righteous? Can I go one righteous? This one is representing Filler, Prager, Cargo. Your question is this.